property in the wares. Yeah, I sent it to you.
That's good.
Cassaro LLC, yeah. So yeah, you should just be able to
hit that thing. I did, yeah, I saw it. Yeah, it worked, shot it, yeah, yeah. All right, I'm gonna go run. So I've got...
I think that means that there are a lot of men in the YouTube channel watching.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
So what do you think? You're in business.
Thank you. Robert. This.
Thank you.
ever have is don't step in my basements.
What?
Ah! I'm pretty glad,
like, right there would be.
See the live stream?
YouTube live stream.
So do you really?
Yeah.
Sweet.
It's
cool.
Where's the camera?
Oh, sorry. Jesus Christ.
It recorded you saying it forever. You run for office.
Hey, it's Chris. I was like, trying to get a house. I think it's going to be the map.
Be a part of stuff.
Checking it out, it's pretty cool. They give you some analytics on it. I don't know how well it'll work in terms of like volumes. It'll show like how many people are watching it.
Yeah, yeah.
That's the health stream, blah blah blah.
We should actually try to record these things. Like
sense.
I mean like a film, like a camera dude. Yeah. Like semi pro.
How are the you guys want a beer?
I get one in a second.
Alright. How was the registration? How'd the registration speak?
So for this, it's like 55 people. Nice. There's always 10 or 15 that show up that don't register.
Awesome.
So people that are too cool to register.
What's on Dan? When did he get here?
He's already here. He's been camping in James John's Island.
Oh, really? Nice.
He rents a, I never met him.
Yeah.
But he rents a Airstream and travels around in the summer. He was like, we'll be in John's Island. I was like, Charleston's not that close to John's Island? You don't have to, like, drive over here?
Yeah, like, it's in traffic.
He's like, I could walk. It's like, I don't want to Google that. Not that close. It requires a car. Maybe a bicycle.
That's funny. Did, let's see. So, like, the guys who've been getting him, who's the guy?
Who's the last dude? remember.
I don't think I came to the last one.
The guy from House? Maybe the last one. Ooh, me and Jesus more often.
Did they, do they
was that really the last one? That was
weird. Like, oh shit, it was last summer.
Did they angle to get, like, on the speaker pipe thing, or are they all, or is that...
That's what they all want.
Only if you draft one.
That's what they all want to do. They're all copying him. They're all copying him. I don't care.
That's all I was thinking. It seems like that's... I remember when I went to...
I mean, but they're awesome, so...
Yeah.
Load them up.
Yeah, exactly.
Nice to cover it. Internet.
It was... She makes cool work. Really nice black lady. She spoke, I think, a lot of her. She was...
Denise James.
Well, she's succeeded.
Yeah, she's
She really worked that hard, and now she's like on basically every circuit in the U.S. and in Europe.
In Europe, yeah, that's
cool. She does. She like organizes it so that she can spend, you know, 2 weeks in Europe and kind of go to 5 or 6 and come back.
That's what she was hired as. I don't know what you call them. I know. What do they call them?
She's an evangelist.
Yeah, evangelist. That's what it was before. Was it Scotch or what was the?
Oh, it's
3M
or
the one that makes Post-it.
Yeah, it's Post-it. Yeah, so she's like a sort of a Post-it.
Sweet. Hey, wait, Zach.
Oh, that's awesome. Can you come in front of the camera and let's replay that?
No.
Everyone in the world, what you're doing?
Yeah.
You.
So
do that.
Today I was like, you stick around tonight, right? Just
software.
It
trumps anything
else. What else you got going on? It's like, here's the
software. Like,
come on, dude. That's the perfect way to get out of this.
I got one
for Kevin. Yeah, really. What do you guys got going on? You got a good project?
Yeah, man. Kevin was just ridiculous. Yeah. Got another really cool one we're working on right now. I don't know how well this computer will file its crazy wrong. This is
that's
a
cool.
Giant website that's made it right now. It's brilliant. There's some cool stuff on there. So this is getting built out right now. This is massive because it's going to be like, like any of the stuff you've been working on. It's going to be basically replicated to a bunch of other theater brands as well. So this is massive.
Hey, Brian.
Cool.
Just unplug that thing. Door.
Oh, no, it's a switch.
We need to put a slide down there, probably.
And then...
It looks
hey. There's like a...
Look good.
There is a... Let's see if I can get my analytics. Let's see if anybody else is watching.
Yeah.
Although they probably just turned off the screen.
What's up?
Carl. What's up, dude?
Hey, man.
I don't know. I just got tired of it, more or less, you know?
Hey, dude. How's it going?
I don't know you.
You trying to turn into some kind of like respectable father or something?
No, I just kind of got the beard got super hot because it was huge.
Yeah, so
like, and then I cut that off and I was like, screw it. So I just went ahead and buzzed the hog too.
Should I keep it this way? We're doing a live stream of the. We'll see how it goes.
What else we got?
Cheetos? The new site for Cheetos?
Oh, that's cool.
I'm attacking that right now.
topics that we had. I was telling him how we were commiserating about the single society, single home page, super low page, super giant images, all down there.
I don't know if it's possible.
So yeah, just make
that be tiny font size. But you say you put the JPEGs on 20%?
Oh yeah, let's say it's like 3%. It's like the grain and stuff. Yeah, it's like a lot of this.
Way to go.
What else?
Little clown park.
Go to Angelica.
That's like an SVG.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What?
Probably the clown car response image.
Yeah.
That way you can basically like have a... Yeah. It's clever though, because you can kind of have an element query inside of the SVG.
I should have called
them. What's going on?
Hey, I'm good.
How you been?
It's
been a while.
Indeed.
Yes.
Finishing up. Almost out of school, so I'm pretty, pretty excited. Got one more quarter left, man. I'm out.
Got any prospects?
Out in September. I'm looking. I'm hoping to find something here in Charleston. So
yeah.
I'm pretty excited about it. I've got a couple freelance things that I'm on the list for.
Are you interning?
I haven't. I work three jobs, so it's been hard to intern. I think I might want to get out and try to like do pick up an internship while this is.
Yeah, you should at least for a few months, especially if you're in your last quarter.
Yeah.
That's how I would if I were you.
Yeah, and then I did a little internship in the school like for a year and a half at the time.
That's cool.
So I did a year and a half worth of work for her. So it's kind of an internship because everything I did, she like looked at and critiqued it and helped me out with it. And it was for clients and deadlines.
Yeah, that's cool. That's good. It's just like having a real portfolio. Like
yeah.
It's so different from having a student portfolio, which is all academic.
Right. Yeah, it's all like real world desserts, like posters and flyers and things that they need for the event.
That's your place, okay.
Yeah, totally.
It was pretty tight.
You're just there.
Awesome. Okay. I got some massive contract here. Yeah. You're getting a BX?
Yeah.
I understand.
Yeah.
We're also going to get in there.
Yeah.
I'm ready for my portfolio show.
But you want to stay here?
I'd like to. I mean, I'm not tied to it, but I'd like to stay here. For a little while, anyways. At least until... a little established and kind of, you know, if I like really like get with a company that really meshes well, then totally want to stay. I love Charleston, it's a beautiful city.
Yeah.
A lot of people out there hiring, it's sort of all over.
There's that too.
Everybody always wants like 2 or 3 years experience. Right, but they just each. You take a lot of time to see if they give you an interview.
I think that's I present myself well enough. Like,
well, I mean, I just think that a lot of times the people who write the job descriptions, it's all wishful. It's either wishful thinking or the people who write it are like human resources. They don't always know exactly what it is that they're writing down. So like, you need to know 15 languages. You don't need to know. You don't need that. You know.
Got through JavaScript Rails or something,
probably fine.
As long as you know something, just
like. Yeah, it's like, you know, base knowledge. And you go into the interview and they're like, can we hang out? And you're like, yeah. And they're like, all right, let's do this.
What's up, buddy?
Good to see you, man.
I do. Hi, how you doing?
How are you?
Good to see you. At the end of the comments. I'm going to press the cross here.
I'm
familiar. He works over at Slant.
He's a good guy.
He graduated from AI too.
Oh,
so
yeah.
That's how I met him. He was,
Quartz.
Hello.
Quartz.
He's a good guy. I think the last time I, like, sat and chatted with you and everybody else here was, like, when House was here.
Yeah. I think that was the last time I was down here.
About a year ago, was it?
Something like that, yeah.
It's crazy.
It's been a while.
It's crazy.
We travel all over the place. We hardly ever go anywhere in South Carolina. So I was out of the state,
right?
You know, for events. And we go to our own events.
Right. Oh, that, yeah, that makes sense.
And not even always men. Sometimes it's just Gene or just me or... Well, it's exciting, man.
Yeah, I'm pumped, dude. I really am.
Yeah.
Really? Have any like cool side projects or anything?
I did. I mean, nothing huge. Like little freelance stuff. I did.
I mean, like for yourself.
Oh, for myself? Yeah, I did. I do. Well, it's for me. It's for my group. I'm a part of a dance community in the area.
Oh, really?
And yeah, I'm a swing dance blues instructor.
Oh, really?
So yeah.
Oh, that's cool. Yeah.
So so we throw a huge party. So this is basically for me because I love it. Like I eat it up, and we throw a big party every year, and I do all the logo design work and all that stuff, and I do it like in my free time when I'm like on a straw and stuff like that. And last year I did a commercial for it. Like the guy's like, "Where'd this come from?" I'm like, "Yeah, I felt like doing something in After Effects." He's like, "All right." He's like,
"That's badass.
That works for you." So it's a lot of fun. So I mean, it's for me, but it's not at the same time. But and then I do some painting stuff, like calligraphy painting stuff that I've been trying to work on lately, trying to get like more of that.
Like brush painting stuff.
Yeah. Yeah. I do. I like working with acrylic. Yeah. So I like.
Acrylic's my medium of choice. Usually too.
It's fun. It's fun stuff. Other than that, I mean, little drawings here and there, like just sketching out stuff and working with a lot of typography stuff. Pretty excited. I'm taking a motion graphics class this quarter just because I love motion graphics and I want to add more to it to my portfolio.
Right.
That's kind of for me. It's an elective. Like I randomly had a random elective pop up that I didn't realize I had it, but I had to take art history, and they're like, "No, you got an elective." I'm like, "All right, let's do motion graphics."
Yeah, probably.
So it's pretty cool.
Crazy, you can do that. I mean, it's all this crap's free.
It's free.
Yeah. Nice speaker. It's brilliant.
Well, we thought like because over here you can see the slide. You we do that?
What's up, man? How you doing?
And he starts presenting.
Yeah, me too.
But no one's really. You get your chin, your throat. Rich had an online throat admirer for a while. A video, a shaving video, and all of a sudden you got all these disturbing comments from someone who kept talking about his throat, his Adam's apple.
It's a little weird.
A lot of interesting people.
Working on anything?
So what's it picking up right now?
Work and our stuff. Oh, there.
Yeah, it's
just a delay.
Yeah, it's
kind of creepy. So now I can't take back what I did?
Like I said, most of the downtime, like during breaks, I'm trying to do my fun stuff.
It's really, yeah. Well, I mean, luckily the stuff that we do, a lot of times
if we did that, we would be doing any
artwork and, you know, just kind of interesting dev stuff, you know, built game. I've seen him on Canvas. Working a lot of that stuff
on Airbnb.
No, it's interesting stuff, but
it's
not necessarily the stuff that I would be doing.
Right. Well, look, the great thing about professionals.
I don't know.
Even stuff that's not necessarily what you like, want to do is still exciting.
Yeah. I mean, the cocktail can be really cool.
You guys know each other? Gene? Matt? Hey. Matt talked about a month ago, maybe?
Yeah.
Something like that.
Yeah.
And
then
I refreshed.
It's
incredible.
I'm gonna grab a
soup. Yeah, that's cool. Yeah, definitely.
Really, really cool talk. Talk all about, like,
power. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. You've seen that talk, right?
I had that same conversation with someone. You know, I was telling her, like, no, it's the most important thing you can learn how to say.
Really hard to say. Yeah, it is. And it's funny, like, the whole video that Jason Santa Maria does about the RSA note, gives the warning signs of, like, why they said it. I got an email yesterday. It's all about, you know, the one about too familiar, like, text talk. The initial email that I got one yesterday, it was, like, how you doing? Can I get animation or something like that? You know, it's like, no, what? Like, who are you?
I was thinking about this like 2 days ago when I was riding home, and I was like, I'm better at saying no. I'm better at saying no to non-clients. Like if a prospect comes up, I can shut them down in a second. But if it's a current client, I'm a little
fussy. Yeah, no, I know.
And I always wind up saying yes if they're like, we need to do this, that, the other.
It's definitely harder. I got roped into, I don't do web design at all, but
client I did a video for wanted some design for a website, and it was really hard to say no to them because, you know, I had done a lot of design that they wanted it based off of. And but I should have just said no because it turned into this, you know, month-long process. And I mean, you know, someone else could have done it way faster, but I'm just like, I don't know.
Why is that creating all kinds of, like, yeah,
yeah,
stress? What's going on this
summer,
man?
Nothing, man.
Taking time off or yeah. run around?
I've been working pretty hard. I've been getting married this year, so all my time is kind of...
Man, you got to hold in. I mean, you know, got two ways. I mean, your time's all going to get, like, eaten up by that, or you just need to now maximize the rest of your time.
Yeah. It's kind of both.
But shit doesn't change. I mean, unless you're marrying, like, a tyrant.
Yeah.
Yeah. I always laugh. I always have this goofy thing with my wife, and she's really funny about it. She laughs at me, but it's like, I can't be there for you if I'm not there for myself.
Yeah.
Which is my, like, selfish excuse for living doing all the shit like it is.
Yeah.
And so it works out really well. She's always been really good about it. Go do this, go do that.
Yeah. That's perfect. That's a great relationship.
Yeah, it is. It's really good. I mean, you can't, like, you both got it. I mean, you guys are both into each other for a reason,
yeah.
So I never understand why people cash on that. Hey, dude, how are you doing, man?
It's good to see you, brother. How are you doing?
And then they're like, what?
Hey, I know.
Hey, I see you. I don't recognize you without the hair anymore.
I know. Yes, I don't recognize you. Now I appreciate your telling me. It's weird. Yeah, that's like the delay.
Google Hangout.
And I walked up to him and I was like, so now after you've done all this silly shit, it'll show up like 5 minutes later and you can't take it back. So I was doing that. I was like,
that's
it wasn't working.
Yeah.
And then 5 minutes later, it's up on the screen.
You're like, oh, shit, I'm shot.
Yeah. But anyway, I want to be all.
I've been together for about 4 years.
For you.
Yeah.
Cool, dude.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Yeah, thanks. We'll be interesting.
When's it going down?
September 29th. It's a big day.
Oh, shit, it's right around the corner.
Yeah.
We got married September 25th here in Charleston.
Oh, cool. Yeah. We're all meeting up in New Jersey.
I was born in Westfield, New Jersey, somewhere kind of outside of the city, and I was only there for like a year or two, but the writer we work a lot with, does a lot of our writing, so I don't know if you know Jenny Bass.
She's working on that website thing.
She's awesome. And one of her good buds in town is her high school buddy, Sarah, who works Grofood. She runs Grofood, you know that thing over there?
Wait, that's
like 5 minutes.
Yeah, so.
Yeah. We put it on this. I'm gonna.
Put the beer bottle right there.
Yeah. I mean, why not just put it over on Casey's desk?
Too much.
I'll stay there and hold it.
Slightly high.
The red for a little time. It will be uncomfortable. Tape it to your chest, like a GoPro.
Yeah.
No.
Just have to make sure.
We could have brought GoPros too. I know. Eventually, we'll get pro about all this and start recording something. Why would we hire other people? Why would we?
This is what we need.
One of them.
It's pretty nice.
Yeah. I think that's
why, too.
Hey,
Dan.
Lights under.
Hey.
Hey, Dan.
Hey.
Andrew.
I'm Gene.
All right. Is that not him?
What can I do for you?
Nothing. I wanted to meet the speaker for tonight, and he thought you were the speaker.
No, I am. It's me.
You're the speaker. Cool.
I'm awesome.
You are?
Great.
Hey, can't wait to hear.
Hey, all
right. Well, I still meet you.
You work here at Blue Iron?
No.
Oh, okay. No. I'm the AIGA guy.
Okay.
Cool.
I'm actually getting here.
So you're from Columbia?
Yeah.
Okay. Who are you with up there?
A company called Period 3.
Period 3.
Yeah, we run a website called Unmatched Style. We do a conference called Converge.
and then I'm president of AIGA.
Is that similar to the Jigsaw thing here?
Similar.
It's more coding.
Yeah.
More design. Did the Fusco go up there for that?
Probably.
They probably did.
Probably did. Yeah. I think I remember seeing one or two of them.
Okay, yeah, I think I saw them.
There's a lot of them.
Yeah, I don't know, I mean, they're awesome. Cool, I'm sorry. I'm a graphic designer. Thanks, graphic designer.
Nice to meet you, Gene.
Yeah.
Meg.
Thanks for bringing speakers up here, man.
We're going to try to do more.
It's a little bit of a desert down here.
That's cool.
How long have you been in AIGA?
I've been in AIGA as a board member for 5 years, and I've been the president for going on two.
Yeah. So if you joined out here, like, you just grab up, do they have meetings here?
Yeah.
I'm part of that meeting.
It's
here.
Free.
Oh, it is. Okay.
So if you're a member, it's free.
Okay. Right. So you meet every week? Or every month, I mean?
We're trying to do something. We haven't done anything the past couple of months down here. We will do, you know, it's a statewide chapter, so it's like Greenville here, Charleston, Columbia here.
I don't know much. I thought about joining, but I'm a freelancer, so it's like,
you have to join. It's like $5.
Yeah.
That's nice.
So good.
Yeah.
Looking forward to your speech, man.
Oh, yeah.
Sure. Sorry about that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Yeah, well, I'll work to see that.
Should have still be there.
Yeah.
That's a concern about people yelling before that shit.
We want it.
It's like,
we know.
Yeah.
We know.
Fine.
Loud for your brother.
I care.
Yes,
I know.
Yeah,
I everything, like, I mean, there is, like, you guys have a little devil of inside, so I'm not sure.
Yeah.
Crazy. So are you going to try to expand it even more next year?
I don't think Columbia can hold
it.
Yeah. It's half it out. Yeah. It's like full. You could maybe go to like 800.
Yeah.
That'd be fun.
Yeah. So you got to did you actually like cap it this year?
Yeah, we had to
cap it. Yeah.
Which was scary. Because I was like, who's going to sell it? Never
yeah.
got it. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, oh shit, there's like fire codes and like city codes. And it's like, oh,
ah, turn it off.
Yeah.
Sweet, man.
We got kind of close into like, we got stuck in mines mode.
Yeah.
Yeah.
About
yeah, if you have that many.
Charleston.
I have that same conversation with every city you go to. I'm like, I want to do them all. It would be awesome. Yeah, it's like if you have enough people in the street, you have to have like whatever you get from the city, they're like, well, I don't see to have that many people in the street. Because they're like, why are there so many people in the street? Who's responsible? Where's your permits? I don't know.
The last night, I guess, the party for the art place.
I like that.
That was awesome.
You like that?
I mean, that
yeah,
was
crazy.
Us just kind of honing in on what was already going on, right?
To a degree.
Yeah.
Yeah, I paid them to let us be part of their party, and then we just
yeah.
I knew it, and
right.
they were like, I don't know. I was like,
yeah.
Let's take the show.
Yeah. Yeah.
And if, after about 30 minutes, it was all us and they were.
Yeah.
It was cool. We had
plenty of beer. All that
yeah, we had attendees buying art.
Oh, yeah.
I saw the. I was walking around, some dude was like, I just bought my first piece of art, man. I don't know how to get it home. I was like, well, I can't help you, but that's
yeah.
awesome. So, really cool. Are you controlling the music?
Yeah.
That's awesome. That's really cool.
Let's see.
Can anybody do that? Or is it just you?
If they're hooked into my. Yeah, if they're. Well, this is
soul control to me.
Connection to my library.
Okay. Nice. So, in other words, no.
Yeah.
That's the way to keep it, man. Like, I'm sorry, it's on my iPhone.
I don't know.
Do your like phone calls or voicemails ever come through? Like,
really? This is it's just so. I
oh, you're remote controlling something else.
Yeah.
Okay. So I've got one of those. I forget what the name of it. Like a speaker, like a Bluetooth.
Yeah.
Every once in a while, I'll be sitting in the living room, and like,
yeah.
my voicemail will play up there, and I'm like, oh shit.
Is it the Jambox?
Yeah,
it's
Jambox.
Yeah, those are cool. I have one too. Yeah.
It's good.
Yeah.
I got like a little tiny one.
Yeah, I do too. Yeah.
Just throw it in your pocket, and you're like, smooth.
Yeah, I bring it out on the boat, and like, because I'm in a boat club, and like, so. Depending on what boat we get, it might have like stereo in it or it might not. So I bring that and it's just instant stereo right there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm gonna get the bigger one.
Yeah. Yeah. So yeah, I think I would get the bigger one too for my house because I've been you know, like
really
barbecues and
yeah.
whatever and it's like unless you're in that room you don't really hear it. So
yeah, the little one's cool for like sitting on your desk.
Yeah.
If it gets too loud, it starts like moving.
Yeah.
Like,
but I mean, like you said, you can actually like you can use it as a speakerphone for like talking or whatever. Which we've used it here a few times. I mean, it's pretty cool. But like, how much I like it.
Yeah, no, not really.
Except for how it's
nobody has it.
I try to stay away.
We need to do something down here. I know. You Carl's something.
Yeah. Well, I mean, we've been working with Carl on refresh.
I've seen it, yeah.
Doing that, so. Haven't seen if he started using
like Woody and one of our interns for like designing out a new logo for them.
Cool.
And I don't know how far if it's done or if we're using it or not. But the last refresh that we did up here, it was about this size and stuff. He started charging $5 across the land to make people understand, like, hey, it's probably worth it.
It's okay. That's awesome.
We're happy to supply the beer and our stuff. Yeah, like, make sure people are coming, like, knowing that, hey, it's going to be worth it.
I'm glad to see that.
Yeah.
That's great. We have not done Refresh Columbia in a few years. We did one last month, and we got like 7 minutes.
Yeah.
We were like, what happened to this community? Where all these people come from?
Yeah.
Awesome. You got to do what I did. We do a lot of video podcasts and stuff like that, so we'll set up the DSLR. It's like a sort of thing.
I don't know. I'm going to go to the next one. Noisette early on with John Knott and Mike Rolanos. B-N-I-F.
PNMI and Architects of Kansas City. And they were like one of the early and one of the biggest sort of like green architects. Bob Orkfiles, like talking to like Steve Jobs or I don't know, he's a fucking amazing, amazing guy. But he was really humble and I was here to talk in Charleston about the walkway they designed in downtown Kansas City that was like over a road, you know, to connect the two buildings. And in the late 70s, it collapsed. Like 12 people were killed, and it was like nuts. And I can't remember what they found was the issue, if it was structural, if it was design, if it was materials, I don't know what. But he just talked about how that profoundly changed forever.
Yeah.
And he carried the weight of that, whether it was his fault or not, he carries the weight of that forever. And it completely changed the way he thought about architecture from that point on, which is kind of like the happy side of that story is it made him adjust his approach to architecture and the environment, even nature, and people. And, you know, it was amazing, amazing talk. Amazingly, like, personal talk. It was really cool. Yeah. So that it's like, fuck, you know, I'm going to leave you. It's going to, you know, it may not, like, destroy some brain cells.
Reputations.
Yeah, it's a reputation. For a sake, for sure.
That's a big
thing. Yeah, reputations are damaged forever on the internet. That could arguably be worse than physical damage, in some cases.
Have you heard anything about something you said to me? About, you know how New York, you have the eye line?
Yeah, yeah.
Have you heard anything about New York?
Yeah, I did. It's like a year ago a dude called me, and I think it's the guy who is the money behind the low line. I think he's a financial dude who has a non-profit and it's all about urban parks. And he was like, I want to do the low line. And he's like, I appreciate that maybe one day there'll be light rail, but that's like a 20-year, 30-year, 40-year pipe dream. And right now, it could be used as a linear park. And so I even did a whole proposal for him, just about, you know, like a website and all that. And then I never heard back from him. And he said, yeah, all right, that's awesome. I'll get back to you when it's time to do something. I don't know where he went. Tom Bradford might know something about it.
I heard about one time from somebody, and I never heard anything.
Yeah, yeah. It's cool shit. I mean, you know, he's like wanted to take that thing up and branch it off to North Charleston.
Right.
You know, and branch it off to wherever else it needs to go. Well, I mean, you know, why not?
Yeah.
I don't know what it takes. And I guess the only problem is I think working with the railroad companies is kind of hard to get them to use it. It's like they make DOTs kind of easy.
Yeah.
They don't want to give up a damn thing.
But yeah, that's what I heard. It's all about the. You know, behind Marshall, you know, that little thing under the freeway.
Yeah.
I'm talking about my bike there.
I rode by there this weekend. I was looking at it.
I rode
up to Nixon and I was riding back.
I rode up to go,
go check those of me down. Let's go swim and grab some more green spots.
Yeah, this sounds good to me.
It's pretty sweet, you know?
Yeah.
They did a nice enough job with the architecture and the service there. And I'm like,
somebody told me it was Plato, Lake of Plato. It's like, is that pretty
in Austin?
They're in San Antonio.
Yeah, all right, that may be it. Yeah, I heard it was someone down in that area.
Yeah.
And then I was talking to Eddie Bella, I guess. Eddie's firm here. We work with sort of related to the, they were their local on-site kind of resource, I think. It's pretty damn nice. I mean, I think there's a lot, it seems to be like there's a lot of controversy around it, like, oh, is this like, I mean, I know a lot of the residents up there are pissed because they're like, these fuckers are like hand-selecting who they want to be, not letting local park circle residents participate, whatever. But the whole premise of the club is always kind of bothered me. Until Rachel and Isma and I went up there, we're like, this is fucking nuts. Because they threw out that whole premise of like a club is like this Republican, well, it's just the style of it's badass. It looks like it's something that actually landed out of Austin, San Antonio. It's, you know, it's Tamagotchi. They're running movie nights. They have art programming there. You know, there's a cost to it, but it's not like joining the Charleston Country Club. It just like it took out all the elitist kind of crap out of it. And you brought that down to sort of say, there's still a definitely a dose of like that makes sense. But it's at least it's pretty fucking competitive. It feels really comfortable. Definitely, you know, Rachel and Isabel and I mean, she's nine and she's like, this place is great, man. She goes up there and spends.
So, are you a member?
She's like a member for a year, I think. We're cheap as shit, so we're usually not able to sell out for anything. I don't know what we do every year. I don't like driving, but I don't like spending a lot of money. So, you know, I'd probably rather go to the beach than go to a place to sit down
with.
Here was a nice day. Like Saturday, we had a really cool day. I went riding, went to the beach, did a bunch of cool shit. We didn't really talk much anymore, so we were like, what do we do tonight? I brought Brennan up there. We just sat and drank some like tacos. It was great, but it was cool. I ate like these really excellent, really good tacos. And so like nine, and we grew up here. I could probably get into that. So cynical as I could be about it, that was it. So I don't know what to do. It's definitely there to help them sell real estate. That's what they're looking for. But they did a pretty sweet piece I was thinking like you know, if you took that concept further, did something like set up bikes. You know, so like, I mean, my problem, I like biking. Can't find to learn how to work on a bike. I have to have the tools and have some knowledge. But like, why wouldn't a place like that, a community club, have like room where they outfit all the tools, all the members in theory, they are owners of all the tools. And you could get in there and work on the bike, ask friends for help, and everything. Imagine a club that has that kind of program. So it's like a 6-week exercise. I mean, you could do all kinds of cool shit. It would basically bring together people. And yeah, it's nice if there's a pool to swim in, a restaurant, a bar to hang out. But have some cool stuff like that to get people engaged in learning and doing shit together. It's not just like, you know, it just has a physical presence with a pool and a nice bar. David Cassaro just celebrated that. Yeah. It seemed like a pretty funny thing. We were laughing about little places like that. They cultivate a little.
There is racism
in there and that.
Yeah. I mean, like so many clubs,
it started
for racism.
Yeah, you're right. It started because people like, I don't want to see anyone else.
But no, I know guys that.
But that's maybe the backstory is that's whether they've evolved to something different, that's where they sort of came from.
Right.
Because a lot of groups of people wanted to exclude and get away from it.
Right.
Yeah.
So now you've got bits of that.
Yeah. In its own way, it's the same thing. You can argue. Yeah. Maybe it's.
I gotta say, it's a kind of appeal to me, though.
Yes.
I just looked at something.
I agree.
Pays the taxes and makes it a small price.
Yeah, it's awesome.
Yeah.
It's
awesome.
Where are you resting?
I live on Morris Street.
Okay, all right, cool.
Yeah. Built a house there and continue to grow. Sometimes people think it's back there with Tully Alley, you know, all those.
Yeah,
it's not there, but it's in that same block. kid in Vermont.
Near St. Paul?
Yeah, it's kind of behind the yard.
It's a
tall building.
All right.
You may never have noticed it.
No, that's what's cool about it.
Yeah. It's three stories, but then there's a little roof thing, tower. And,
the other side of the year, he also
comes out. Yeah. But now people are starting to rent it, can I have this month of April?
The thing that really worries me now is like about Molly and Sullivan. It's the volume of people. It just seems like it's going to be impossible.
Well, that's because we're living in a place that's fucking growing.
And it's going to get worse the next 10 years.
Yeah.
So maybe they need to figure out like how do you create some system for shuttling people back and forth. Otherwise, it's like if you're going out the door into the beach by 9 o'clock, if you come back anytime after like 1, I don't know what you would do with that. He's got a causeway to eat both of those islands. I don't really think the answer would be, maybe it has to be, but building more roadway would kind of suck if they did, but maybe they have to. So the other answer would be, all right, can you run a bus, ferries, and a bus?
Yeah.
And even stick racks on that bus, just like you do in Colorado to carry skis or snowboards? I mean, you go back to Solvents, but you have to come to college. I can't imagine that today. Like going out there and jumping off whatever station you can find. Is that inconceivable?
The thing is,
things are going to have to melt down before they would ever have that possibility.
Yeah, yeah. But I mean, here we are in this place that more people are moving to. It's like Austin, Texas, same thing. Millions of people, thousands of people moving every month. And we're sprawling out. But there's a little bit of infill happening. I mean, I'm a poor dude.
Yeah, I agree. There's still a lot of potential in that.
Immense
spaces that are wasted. Yeah. But you're right. So that's the opportunity. That is also going to bring in all the more reason, low lines or ferries or ways of getting people in and out of these like high attraction places. These days, the last two or three years, I've been going to the mountains. I think like my compass is like kind of like redirecting that way. And I don't know why. I don't think it's because of that. I like it here. I think it's probably more because more time goes by, the more I like this season and mountains. So I can still intertwine in all this, and I can't see getting out of that. My daughter's already in grade.
The school thing. No, I'm going through the same thing.
After college, I could definitely, that's like six, seven years, I could definitely see reversing the flow to where I was up there full time and made it here outside.
But I'm getting serious about it. Same thing. I mean, I've got two houses here. I could sell one of them. I have a house up over in that case somewhere.
Is he
all set up, I guess?
I need to do that. I'll give myself a day.
Alright, hey everybody, welcome to another AIGA South Carolina event. We'd love to have Dan here. Is everybody say welcome to the other guys? If you like what you see, join AIGA, support this stuff, try to do more stuff. So thanks for coming out, and I'll shut up. Thank you, Dan.
Can you guys hear me?
Yeah.
Louder? Quieter?
Bring it up.
So, I'm really happy to be here. I just want to say real quick that I'm super happy to be in Charleston. I have given some talks recently in cities that will not be named, but every time I go there, I have to say, I'm really happy to be here. I love this city, and like, it's not always necessarily true. Where's that clapping coming from? Oh, it's the feedback from the Google chat. But I always have to say that, and it's not necessarily true, and then I feel kind of bad about it, and I don't have to lie about it now, because I really love Charleston. We've been having an awesome time. We've been here for like 4 days, and we've been like swimming every single day, and I'm like covered in bug bites and scratches and stuff, and it like really feels like summer here, and yeah, we just love it. So I want to say thanks for having us. Can we turn the Google chat off? Because it's like I'm hearing everything that I'm saying. It's messing me up really bad. Where is it coming from? All right. You guys hear that?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, I'm just going to power through. I'm a designer and illustrator. I have my own little design shop in Brooklyn called Young Jerks. It's just me. I'm actually a nice guy. I said I'm a graphic designer, but what I really love to do is make type treatments, black and white lettering, logos, things like that. And I'm going to show you guys a bunch of projects.